Not quite yet. I'm not sure. Hello, it's Joe Graber again for another LightBoard training video. For this video, I'm going to assume that you have already watched my simple setup video, that you already have the LightBoard turned on, you already have the camera and the monitor on, and you have the effect B turned on so that you can write and it'll be forward. The next step is connecting a presentation to the LightBoard, because you're going to want to be able to present your material. So let me show you how to do that. So after you're in the LightBoard room, right next to the video capture device, you're going to see an HDMI cable. The black HDMI cable is connected to an adapter that changes it from HDMI to mini DisplayPort. Depending on what computer you have, you're going to use one of those or another. I have Microsoft Surface and it has a mini DisplayPort, so I'm going to go ahead and plug that in. Okay, once you get it all the way plugged in, it should act just like you're connecting it to a projector. And you'll see the screen turn off momentarily and turn back on. It is now sending that information to the video switcher board. The whole purpose of the video switcher board is to combine the image coming from the camera and the image coming from your computer. Video switcher board is just underneath the light board, and you can see that there's a slider that you can slide back and forth. When I do that, I'm actually choosing between what's on my computer and what's coming out of the camera. So the next thing I want to do is go back to my presentation and present. I have a Microsoft PowerPoint presentation with a black background, and I'm just going to click Present. You can see now when I go back and I use the white feature, I'm going in between the camera and my presentation. And I can wipe back and forth to choose how much I want of it. There's different modes. There's wipe and there's mix. Wipe is where you come from one side of the screen to another, whereas mix, you're mixing the two signals together, and you can actually have yourself being present inside the presentation. Okay, so I'm going to show you some examples of how you might want to use this and how the way that you plan on using the video switcher board dictates how you want to create your presentation. Okay, so here's a presentation where I have the slider on wipe, and I can just show half of the screen. If I want to do a presentation like this, where I'm over here and my information's on the other half, you'll notice that in the middle, the two signals mix a little, but then my hand fades away as it goes further along. If you want a presentation like this, you're going to create a PowerPoint presentation with a black background and all of your information on one side. And then you can mix it by bringing that slider in just halfway, so you get halfway the presentation and the other half is from the camera. Another option is maybe you want to be inside your presentation.
Not quite yet, I'm doing something, bud.
In that case, you'd want to click on mix and mix the two signals together. If I mix the two signals together, you notice now I'm still here behind the writing of my presentation. And you can make a presentation where the information is anywhere on the screen and you're inside of it. So you could have information popping up, like the reasons you might want to use a light board. Your students want to see you. Glowing equations are cool. So you can set up these presentations the way that you want to interact with them. I have another example here from math. If you wanted to introduce writing point slope form and actually writing on a graph, you can put your presentation up here and you can actually draw on it. Now what I did, it's a little tip, is I actually took a regular whiteboard pen and I made a line on the lightboard that you can't see. And I made that line by paying attention to the monitor and putting it exactly where I want. And now when I'm in the video, I would just go ahead and say, I'm going to make this line, I trace right over it. And I could say, well, that's, you know, y equals x plus 2 or something like that. So, how you want to use your presentation will dictate how you want to create it for bringing it into the LightBoard. So hopefully that gives you an introduction to how to incorporate your presentation in with the LightBoard and using the video switcher. There are a lot more advanced features, but I want to keep it simple at this point. If you have more questions, you can contact me or eLearning. Thank you very much.